Officer TR Chouhan. I'm ex-employee, Union Carbide India Limited. I joined Union Carbide Bhopal plant on 11th August 1975 as a training chemical plant operator. After completion of my training, I was absorbed as a regular plant operator. During the training, on-job training, I worked in the formulation plant, in the pilot plant of Bhopal Agriculture Product Division in phase one. After that, actually, originally I was appointed for the phase two. So in 1977, I started working in Sabine plant. In Sabine plant, they were manufacturing carbaryl by reacting alpha naphthal with MIC. This carbaryl is in slurry form. The technical name of the carbaryl was Sabine. It is insecticide, and as per our company, it was safest insecticide because the Sabine is it can easily biodegrade in the soil. When I started working in Sabine plant, so during the training we were told that this is very sophisticated plant, and the Bhopal unit is going to manufacture MIC. It is the second plant in the world, and it is based on the advanced technology of 20 years of experience of a Virginia plant. On that basis, we are going to start all these phase two plants. That includes Sabine plant, alpha naphthal plant, carbon monoxide plant, and MIC plant. But when I started working in Sabine plant, there's a lot of problem in the process. So they did lot of modifications, and those modifications bypassed the safety of the plant. So their main target was to produce maximum, to yield maximum production, and they bypassed the safety aspect of the plant personnel, those who were working there. So there's a very big problem of pollution during manufacturing of the Sabine technical. One example is charging of alpha naphthal in MIC reactor. So the original design was to crush out the alpha naphthal solid that was coming in the drum from the USA. So first the jaw crusher will crush, then they put in a molten tank. After melting the alpha naphthal, they were charging alpha naphthal through pipeline to the reactor. But this system was not working. There's a lot of problem of plugging of the lines. So they shut down that, dismantle that system, and they were pounding alpha naphthal solid by the contact lever by hand manually. Then they put in a gunny bag, and after that they are lifting with the trolley to the near the reactor. Then they are opening the manhole of the reactor, and manually they were charging the alpha naphthal into the reactor. It's very harmful. There's a lot of pollution, but because it is done by the contact lever, so but even that, the people, those who are working in the surrounding, they were exposed of the MIC, carbon tetrachloride, trimethylamine, and so many other chemicals. Those were used in the plant. Like that, they modified in the drying system, in solvent recovery system. They changed their process in the some continuous system into the batch process. So after 1.5 years, I was transferred to the alpha naphthal plant. In the alpha naphthal plant also, there's a lot of problem in the process, in the subsystems. So they did more and more modification in alpha naphthal plant, and they run alpha naphthal plant near about 4 years, but they have not got a single kg of pure alpha naphthal from that plant. Finally, they closed down that plant in 1992, and that plant was dismantled after the disaster, but the production was stopped in 1982. In March 1982, I was transferred to the MIC plant. So they have given me a transfer letter. In that they mentioned that you are going to provide another 6 month training for the MIC plant. So I started working in MIC plant, and I was given only 1 week training, classroom training, and they asked me that after 15 days you have to take independent charge of the any subsystem of the MIC plant. So I refused to take independent charge in MIC plant, because I asked them that you have given me letter in that it is mentioned that you are going to provide a 6 month training. Why you are not providing 6 month training? So I refused to work independent. And finally, with the higher management, it was settled down that I am going to take charge of one subsystem. So I was taking charge of, after 22 days training, I was taking charge of the storage area of the MIC plant. That include MIC storage tank, monomethylamine storage tank, chlorine storage tank, chloroform storage tank, caustic storage tank. And till the disaster, I was working in the storage area only. So when I started working in the MIC plant, the technology of the MIC plant was imported from the Union Carbide Corporation by the Union Carbide India Limited. The other two plant technology was developed by Union Carbide India Limited. But the MIC was MIC production was based on the imported technology that was provided by Union Carbide Corporation. And during the classroom training, we were told that it is advanced technology. But similar to other plant, I have seen so many problems in the MIC plant. There was a leakage of the forging, chloroform, hydrochloric acid, MIC, and mixture of complex mixtures. This corrosion pipeline from continuous to batch process and various system. But there was a lot of accident, minor and major accident in MIC plant. So in December 1981, there was a forging leak, and the three personnel, maintenance person, were exposed by the forging, and one of them was died after 72 hours in the hospital. So through our union leader, we raised this problem about the safety of the plant, and we wrote letter to the concerned authorities, to the government, to Union Carbide Corporation, to the central government, to the chief minister, and the concerned higher authorities. But it was not taken seriously. Then in 1982, there was another leak from the MIC plant. That was the trailer of the 1984 disaster. So those people, poor people died, they were exposed by the complex mixture, include MIC and hydrochloric acid and chloroform from the one subsystem. So these poor people left their houses in the night, and they came back in the morning. And similar thing happened in 1984. But it was not taken either by the Union Carbide India Limited nor by the Union Carbide Corporation. And even the government and concerned authority has not taken seriously about the safety of the plant. And after that, the government has made an inquiry about the safety of the plant. And finally, they give decision, the plant is okay, the safety is okay. So after that, we started working, taking during working, we are taking our personal safety. If there's a leak, we stop working. And when the leak is over, then we started working. But there was no final solution. We made agitation through union and asked the poor people surrounding the factory that you come with us, otherwise if anything goes wrong in the plant, you will be die. So this thing was published by only one journalist, that is Rajkumar Keswani, and in the local newspaper, Rappar, but it was not taken seriously. So after that, there was a heavy deterioration in the plant, in the process, in the safety. They have transferred some operators in November 84, and they have not given a single week training, and they were taking full place charge of the MIC plant and their subsystem. In 1982, Union Carbide Corporation has made a SEPI survey of the Bhopal plant, and they have found so many problems in the plant, and they listed out all those major concern and my concern. There was a recommendation how to solve all this problem. So that follow-up was on till the disaster. The similar safety survey was done in 1984, because I think in May 1984 there was a leak in the West Virginia plant. After that they made a safety survey, and that report was published in September 1984. So there's also in West Virginia plant some problem related to the safety, and the major concern was the contamination of the storage material, storage tank material, and the runaway reaction in the storage tank. So after few months, I think September 1984, October, November, after 2 months, there was a runaway reaction in Bhopal plant. Same type of that reaction took place in Bhopal plant. About that, they were worried in West Virginia plant. So these two reports kept as a business confidential. Each and every pages, it is written business confidential. About the plant problem, it was not informed those people who are directly working in the plant. Even the higher official not informed those who are working directly into the plant. They are taking some decision, immediate decision. They were not aware about the problem, what type of problem is there. So there are so many factors related to the disaster, and if you will see all those factors and you will relate all these factors, you will find the 2nd and 3rd December was the pre-planned date and time for the disaster. After the disaster, I came to know through journalists, through media people, through NGOs about the West Virginia plant and about the functioning of the West Virginia plant and Bhopal plant. So the situation was horrible. The design was provided of MIC plant was the Union from the Union Carbide Corporation, and we were told it is based on the advanced technology after getting the 20 years experience. But the plant was not a carbon copy of the West Virginia plant, and they were saying it is advanced technology. It was not at all any advanced technology. It was very simple design. And after few years I came to know the design was provided for the Bhopal plant was unproven design, untested design of the MIC plant. That was the main cause for the disaster.